Hi everyone! Have you ever wondered what the inverting and non-inverting inputs on op-amp ICs actually are and what the differences is between them? Do you think we need to apply a negative voltage to the inverting input and a positive voltage to the non-inverting input? For example, on pin number 13, which has a negative sign, should we connect a negative voltage? Well, in this video, we're going to practically examine this topic. First of all, I'll explain the circuit to you, and then using an oscilloscope, we'll input a signal into the inverting and non-inverting inputs to see what the op-amp output looks like. In this circuit, I am using the PA10324 IC. This IC is an op-amp that has four operational amplifiers inside. Op-amps have many applications and are used in simple circuits as amplifiers or comparators. However, when we connect the output back to the input, which is called feedback, we can design much more complex circuits. Feedback is kind of like feeding the output of the circuit back into it to change its performance. The basic function of an op-amp IC is that it calculates the voltage difference between the inverting and non-inverting inputs, and based on that, activates or deactivates the output. It's as if it's comparing these two inputs and showing the result at the output. This is an amplifier, which is usually represented by triangular shape. In this IC, pin number 4 is the VCC pin, which is used to power on the IC. And pin number 11 is the ground pin, which is the negative of the circuit. Pin number 14 is the op-amp output. Pin number 13 is the inverting input, or the negative input. And pin number 12 is the non-inverting input, or the positive input. Remember a very important point. The positive and negative signs that you see on the input don't mean that you necessarily have to use positive and negative voltages. These signs only show how these inputs affect the output signal, which we will practically examine in the following. Okay, voltage enters the IC and the op-amp turns on. The op-amp inputs should never be left floating because they may pick up noise and cause interference in the operation of the circuit. For this reason, we connect the input to ground using 2.2 kilo ohm resistors. This ensures that the inputs always have a specific voltage. To show that the op-amp output has been activated, we place an LED with a 2.2 kilo ohm resistor on pin number 14. When the output is activated, the LED lights up. This is the circuit that we have built on this breadboard. All right. Now, we want to start the experiment. We connect the first oscilloscope probe to the op-amp output, which is pin number 14. This probe shows us the waveform of the op-amp output. We also connect the second oscilloscope probe to the output of the function generator. A function generator is a device that can generate value signals such as a square waveform, sine waves, etc. Now, we connect the output signal of the function generator first to pin number 12 and then to pin number 13, and we see the result on the oscilloscope. Okay, now what happens? Pin number 12 of the op-amp is the non-inverting input, or the positive input. This input does not invert the signal. That is, if we give it a square waveform, we will see a square waveform at the output as well. But pin number 13 is the inverting input, or the inverter. That is, it reverses the signal that we give to it at the output. In fact, the op-amp calculates the difference between these two pins and activates the output based on that. In this experiment, we only give a signal to one of the inputs. Pay attention to this graph. A square wave signal enters pin number 12. This pin is non-inverting. When the signal reaches the input, we also see the same signal at the output. That is, wherever the signal is on at the input, the voltage is high, the signal is also on at the output. And when the signal turns off, the voltage drops, the signal also turns off at the output. So, both graphs are approximately on top of each other. Of course, depending on the voltage we use, the size of the signal may change, but the shape of the signal remains the same square wave shape. Now, if we apply the signal to pin number 13, or the inverting one that has a negative sign, the signal will be inverted at the output when the signal enters. That is, wherever the signal is on at the input, the signal is off at the output, and vice versa. This is the concept of inverting and non-inverting. So, the positive input creates the same input waveform at the output, and the negative input causes the signal to be inverted at the output. In this circuit, the inputs are connected to ground using 2.2 kΩ resistors. Pin number 4 is connected to the positive voltage, and pin number 11 is connected to ground. We have also put a resistor for the output so that the LED lights up. Now, we want to practically examine this issue on the oscilloscope. According to the explanation I gave, I prepared the circuit. The signal you see on the oscilloscope is the same input signal that is not yet connected to the op-amp inputs and is only connected to the oscilloscope. The second channel of the oscilloscope is also connected to the op-amp output. Currently, no signal is seen because no signal is connected to the inputs. I have also put an LED in the output to see the output frequency. Frequency means the number of times the signal is repeated per second. Now, we enter the signal to the inverting and non-inverting inputs, respectively. Pin number 12 of the op-amp is the positive input. First, we enter the signal to this pin. Pay attention to the oscilloscope. In the input signal, wherever the signal is on, the signal is also on at the output. I entered the signal with a low frequency so that you can see the LED turn on and off well. So, this signal that is seen on the oscilloscope is for the non-inverting input. That is, the signal has not been inverted, and the input signal and the output are the same in terms of appearance. Now, I want to enter the signal to pin number 13. This pin is negative or inverting. Pay attention to the oscilloscope. This is the input signal. Here the signal is on, but in the output the signal is off. Now, wherever the signal is on at the input, the signal is off at the output. So, entering the signal at the inverting pin causes the signal to be inverted at the output. This is used in many circuits. By using feedback and applying it to the inverting and non-inverting pins, we can create different and desired results at the output. For example, when the signal is connected to the inverting pin, I change the type of signal in the input. In this case, the signal is on for a long time in the input, but in the output, only in the part where the signal is off, the op-amp output is active. Now, if we give the input to the non-inverting pin, the shape of the output signal will also change. The time the LED is on proves this. Pay attention to the oscilloscope. Well, I hope this video has been helpful for you. Please like the video, and if you have any questions, write in the comments. Thank you for watching the video.